Assalamu alaikum, students. Today I am with another topic related to your mechanical properties of solids. And first, we should be aware of some terms. One of the terms that is called as a deforming force. Deforming force. What is it? Deforming force is simply a force which is applied on a body, but it does not accelerate the body. It does not bring the It does not bring motion into the body. But what does it? It changes. It is the force. It is the force which changes what size or shape of the body. Its purpose is not to bring any kind of acceleration to the body. Its purpose is to change the size and shape of the body. Then there is one another term that's called as elasticity. What do you mean by elasticity? It is the property of regaining. Property of regaining. Original configuration. When original configuration of a body, when deforming force is removed. Then one other property that's called as a perfectly elastic body. What do you mean by perfectly elastic body? Perfectly elastic body means if you are going to remove, perfectly elastic body, that simply means if your body regains 100% of its original configuration, that's called as the perfectly elastic body. Or what I mean to say, when a body completely regains its configuration, that is called as what? Perfectly elastic body. There are terms plastic body or plasticity. Plastic body or plasticity is first to that very body which does not regain its original configuration. Should be aware of. You might sometimes come with the term plasticity. What do you mean by plasticity? Plasticity is the term that the body is not regaining its body. Is not regaining its configuration. Once the body is not regaining, it is the property by virtue of which a body does not regain its configuration when forces are removed. When forces applied on it are removed, that very thing is called as what? Plasticity. And then there comes the term perfectly plastic body. Perfectly plastic body means a body which has no tendency to at all to regain its original size, which doesn't have any kind of tendency. Once the deforming force is applied, then that is a complete permanent change in that very body. There isn't any restoring force developing in the body so that it will regain it is what it will regain it is state. That is called as the perfectly plastic body. Now there is some terms. Now there is a term that's called as a stress. What is stress? As you know, when a deforming force is applied on a body, once we apply deforming force on a body, once if we are having this as a body, and on this very body, we are going to apply some force. Once this very deforming force applied to the body, it causes some change in the configuration. That terms molecules of which this very body is made. So It causes change in the configuration of the body. As a result of that, the molecules of body suffer relative displacements. This very molecule tends to move like this. This very molecule tends to like move this. It reached here. It reached here. And if you are going to see, this will be the change. So one is there are the displacements. There is change in the configuration. These very relative displacements of the molecules give rise to some internal restoring force. One is this very. As you might have seen, once you pull a spring, if this is a spring and you are going to pull it like this in this very direction, you are going to apply force. This is a rigid one here. So what? It will be expanded. Once you will remove the force, once you will release this very spring, it will try to regain its original configuration. So what makes this very body to bring back its original configuration? That is the restoring force, the internal force which bring the body back to its original configuration. That very internal, what is stress now? Now stress is defined as the internal restoring force developed per unit area of the body, which tends to bring the body back to its original configuration. So simply I will say stress equals to what? Restoring. Restoring force per unit area. So how much will be the restoring force acting per unit area? That will give us the stress acting on the body. Now if there is no permanent deformation, that is there is absence of plastic behavior of the body, then the restoring force is equal in magnitude but opposite in direction to the applied force. If I have applied this as a force of 10 Newton, then there will be, if this is not a permanent change of, and if the body is going to regain its original configuration, then there will be a restoring force, Fr, I will say, that will be in this very direction. So at that very time, in absence of plastic behavior of the body, the restoring force is equal in magnitude but opposite in direction to the applied deforming force. Thus, mathematically, I will say stress is what is equal to the external force, because now the restoring force comes out to be the applied force. That's why we place simply stress equals to what? Force over area, and this force is the applied force. If you are going to check for the unit will be Newton per meter square. And if you are going to check for dimensions, the dimensions for stress will be M1, L minus 2, and T minus 2. These will be the dimensions for what? These will be the dimensions for this very stress. This is all for today. Tomorrow I'll be with another lecture. Till then, Allah Hafiz.